Oh, look, another series about an antisocial hero who is very good at video games. Could it be that it is aiming at a specific type of viewers? Whatever the answer is, here comes yet another show about some waste of life who does nothing but playing video games all day and is all of a sudden thrown in a life or death situation where we are supposed to cheer for him despite being a total jerk. It's about a video game that is something between Counter-Strike and Bomberman getting real after the protagonist is sent to fight other players. Then it becomes Battle Royale in a Predator's setting, meaning a bunch of people that need to kill each other sent via parachute to a remote tropical island. And yes, it sounds interesting at first until you see how silly it plays out. Of course, you need to have some suspension of disbelief when watching a fictional work, but this anime is constantly begging you to point your finger at it and yell, "That can't happen!" The laws of physics make absolutely no sense. When a bomb explodes right next to you, you will be hurt from the noise, the shrapnel, and the shockwave no matter how many times you flip in the air. Also, an explosion has a radius of several meters and is definitely way more than just a few square centimeters around it. So imagine how silly it looks when a dozen bombs explode all around the protagonist, and he remains perfectly fine even when he's a sitting duck. Of course, this weird phenomenon occurs only for the protagonist, since everybody else dies in one hit. It is impossible to be immersed in the series, and it's not because lots of improbable things keep happening. One of my favorite animes, Hokuto no Ken, where people explode like balloons and the script is full of nonsense. The thing that makes all the difference between that and Batum is that it never tries to make a distinction between reality and fiction. They never say, that is a video game and is fake, while this is a death game and is real. When you make separations like this, it's like you are demanding from the viewer to think about it, thus making it far easier to spot the improbabilities and realize the so-called real death games are as fake as playing a video game. Since the script is so bad, the characters suffer from it as well. It would be interesting just to see how each of them would react in a life or death situation, but because of the video game logic the show uses, it makes them act stupid and the drama surrounding them doesn't work one bit. The protagonist, for example, is being rewritten every 5 minutes. It's impossible to tell what his personality is, since he acts completely different in every scene. And no, it's not because he adjusts to the situation he is in, he literally becomes a different person depending on how the plot wants him to behave. In a similar way, every other character has two lines of a personality, and even those are presented in an extreme way. They are all way too evil or way too stupid, to the point they are indeed like video game caricatures and not real people taking place in a real death game. The deaf protagonist, for example, is a sexy blonde schoolgirl, which makes all people around her to wanna rape her on first sight. She's also accidentally the one the protagonist is married to in the game, something which is so easy to happen in real life. She is the main source of fan service, and the animators never miss the chance to zoom on her privates. As for her personality, it is also rewritten based on the demands of the script. She is supposed to be afraid of men, unless the plot says she needs to trust them right away, so they can betray her. Then she will not trust men thereafter, until the plot needs to trust them immediately once more. The protagonist's mother was the one who wanted her son to be sent to the death game because he was mean to her. Because that is what parents do when their kids are impolite. They send them to be killed in some sadistic game instead of seeking help from any one of the thousands of humanitarian organizations out there. The blonde chick, on the other hand, was chosen by her best friends. There was an incident where they got raped, but she escaped, called the police, caught the rapists, and saved their lives. As a thanks, they believed she should have stayed and gotten the same punishment like the best friend she was supposed to be, instead of the unforgivable act of not letting them die by doing nothing. That makes sense. I almost feel sorry for all the money Studio Madhouse wasted on making this thing. It looks gorgeous and feels far more realistic compared to your average anime. I can even place it next to Death Note in terms of atmosphere and cinematics. Many secondary characters have some really ridiculous pitches in their voice that makes them sound very retarded. But other than that, it looks great and makes you wish that was the only thing which was bad in this show. It is just another stupid anime a la Deadman Wonderland or Future Diary. Just a nonsense and edgy violence for low-tier popcorn entertainment. And it fails even at that, because it keeps telling you it is not a video game, but a real death game.